we fight our friends. Kill our nation. I told Jehovah, there is nothing too difficult for you. Kill our nation.
Thank you, Jesus. With your dancing too. And your clapping unto the Lord. We appreciate God cheerfully for counting you alive to be in his house this morning. Every living soul.
Brought about
the reality that every year they are being celebrated, both the dead and the living. That's why they call it annual remembrance day. That's why I type this message. What will you be remembered from? What will you be remembered for? This will take us to some scriptures. I want us to know the fact that there are two ways by which people can be remembered. Either for good or for bad. That's why it's a question that we must prepare to answer. I'm reading from Judges chapter 5. Judges chapter 5. That is the book after Joshua. Before Ruth. Chapter 5. I will read the first 9 verses. Then sang Deborah and Barak the son of Abinadab on that day, saying, praise ye the Lord for the avenging of Israel, when the people willingly offered themselves.
Baraki, ọmọ Abinadab, kọrin ní ọjọ́ náà wípé nítorí bí àwọn olórí ti ṣáájú Israeli, nítorí bí àwọn ènìyàn ti fi tinútinú wá ẹbí Olúwa.
Hear, O ye kings, hear, give ear, O ye prince. I, even I, will sing unto the Lord. I will sing praise to the Lord God of Israel.
Ẹ̀gbọ́ ẹ̀yin ọba, ẹ̀fẹ̀tí sí sílẹ̀, ẹ̀yin ọmọ aládé, èmi àní èmi yóò kọrin sí Olúwa, yóò kọrin sí Olúwa Ọlọ́run Israẹli.
Lord, when thou wentest out on Seir, when thou marchest out of the field of Edom, the earth trembled and the heavens dropped. The clouds also dropped water.
Olúwa, nígbà tí ìwọ jáde kúrò ní ṣe ìrì, nígbà tí ìwọ yan jáde láti pa pápá Edomu wá ilẹ̀ ní títí, àwọn ọ̀run sì kan sílẹ̀, àní àwọn sọ́nà pẹ̀lú kan sí omi.
The mountains melted from before the Lord, even that Sinai, from before the Lord God of Israel.
Àwọn òkè ńlá yọ níwájú Olúwa, àní sí ó ní yọ níwájú Olúwa Ọlọ́run Israẹli.
In the days of Shamgar, the son of Anat, in the days of Tyre, the highways were occupied and the travelers walked through highways.
Ní ọjọ́ Amagari, ọmọ Anati, ní ọjọ́ Joeli, àwọn ọ̀nà òpópónà, àwọn èrò sì ń rìn ní ọ̀nà ìkọ̀kọ̀.
The inhabitants of the villages ceased. They ceased in Israel until that I, Deborah, arose. That I arose a mother in Israel.
Àwọn olórí tọ́jú Israẹli, wọ́n tán títí èmi Deborah fi dìde, tí èmi dìde bí ìyá Israẹli.
They closed new doors. Then was war in the gates. Was Sarah the shield of piercing among 40,000 in Israel?
Nígbà wọ́n sì yan Ọlọ́run tuntun, nígbà náà ni ogun wà ní ibodè. Àárín àṣà tàbí ọkọ̀ tàbí láàrin ẹgbàá ogun Israeli yìí.
Verse 9. My heart is toward the governors of Israel that offered themselves willingly among the people. Bless ye the Lord.
Àyà mi sì fà sí àwọn aláṣẹ Israẹli, àwọn tí wọ́n fi tinútinú wá nínú àwọn ènìyàn. Ẹ fi Olúwa.
Hebrew chapter number 11.
Hebrew orí kọkànlá.
I used to call the book of Hebrew the book of heroes.
Mo máa ń pe ìwé
Hebrew
ìwé àwọn tí ó ṣẹ́gun.
The book of heroes and heroines.
Ìwé tí àwọn tí ó ṣe. Àwọn akọni lọ́kùnrin
tàbí. Hebrew chapter 11.
Ìwé Hebrew orí kọkànlá.
I take it from verse 32.
Láti ẹsẹ̀ kejìlélọ́gbọ̀n.
And what shall I more say? For the time would fail me to tell of Gideon and of Barak and of Samson and of Jephthah, of David also and Samuel and of the prophets. Who through faith subdued kings, wrought righteousness, obtained promises, stopped the mouth of lions. Waged the violence of fire and hit the edge of the sword. Out of weak plants who are made strong, what valiant in fact, taught to fight the armies of the armies. Women received their dead raised to life again, and others were tortured, not accepting deliverance, that they might obtain a better resurrection. May you also obtain better resurrection in the name of Jesus. And as my fellow intercessors, may moral opponents and imprisonment.
Amen. He
was home. They were so solemn. Happiness was laid in the soul. Years now.
Yeah,
beloved, this is is a lesson. For you and I,
that
we have much we can do for our generation.
And
the fact that this, we read about Deborah, a woman of faith and power, who led men to the battle of Egypt. Deborah said, when there is no one in Israel, I, Deborah, I stood as mother in Israel. Mother in Israel.
One of the things that is saving my mind is this.
within the period of the coronavirus break last year, about 6 to 7 months. So people are lost in the world, and we are searching for them now. Already to get them back. They are not ready to come back home. They have been taking the
world.
Lord, what will you be remembered for? The Bible gave us the insight about the man called Noah. Among the people at that generation, he was considered as trustworthy, reliable person, dependable personality, somebody that God can pick among the millions. I am going to send it for you for this generation. God has picked him up. What a wonderful man. And he built an ark.
What's it called for you?
The question is this: can God depend on me today? Can God rely on me today? Can God pick me out of millions? Can God pick you out of hundreds and keep you out of silence? What happened to this heartbeat? Can God find somebody like my you?
Who
will help this dying generation? Our generation is dying. God is looking for somebody for you. God is looking for another man. What am I doing? What are you doing? Are you caring for the perishing? Rise for salvation of somebody. What about Abraham? A man that we can call obedience person. The Lord gave him instruction. Go to a place he has never been
with.
Do what God has not ever instructed anyone to do. And he took it. No wonder it was counted unto him righteousness. And what is another word for righteousness? Perfect obedience to God. You cannot be counted righteous. If you are disobeying God.
Beloved,
what shall you be remembered for? What shall you be remembered for? There is a man called Joseph. This man is loaded with quality. Some days ago, I considered the life of Joseph, and I gave the name of Joseph in the name of abbreviation. J-O-S-E-P-E. I find Jesus in Joseph. I see holiness of Jesus in Joseph. Here was a man who majority of us, if you have what you find yourself near, you found himself. But because of his holiness, he decided to stand by God.
And he had
to suffer.
That
to continue his sin in this place. That is one thing. Another unique thing about Joseph was that he was a man that had large
heart.
What Joseph did, Lord, was highly unique. People that planned to kill him in his
eyes.
He saw them when they were deliberating. He saw them.
Only one.
When they were deliberating, let's kill him.
They
threw him inside the pit.
He
knew that the hammer destroyed him. In his eyes, he was no longer a baby. They saw him. Only for him to become somebody in the near future.
I've
met this set of people again.
And
gave them all their
emotions.
Oh my God. A lot of people are going about with heavy contamination. Because they are not ready to forgive and forget somebody that offended them. If you put yourself in the position of Joseph, what will you do? Beloved, what will you be remembered for? Moses is a unique man. A man of integrity.
The
Bible classifies him as the one that is more meek than any other man by then. The man called Moses was loaded with anointing. Two powers that has never happened before. It was through Moses that Resin encountered the power of God that caused it to separate. No one can talk about Resin today without mentioning the man called Moses. What will you be remembered for? What about Joshua? That man called Joshua. The one that provided the judgment of the children of Israel. The judgment of the children of Israel. So he brought this land.
Oh,
you're a very good year for you. I need to stop here. Because we have much to mention. But let me add this. These keys are important. For those we have good record for tomorrow. Number one. Separate yourself from the system of this world. If you want to live your life like the people of the world are living it, you can't be a good hero in the hand of God. These are part of things we can drive out of those heroes. Number two. Take Jesus as your best friend. You can have many friends, but let Jesus be your best friend. Number three, learn from the past heroes through the scriptures. We have made mention of some of them. There are still many that have not come across with them. The last thing you need to do is that connect your life to the people that can help you physically or spiritually. Don't forget evil communication, corrupt good manner. Evil communication, corrupt good manner. And finally, destroy the works of flex in your life. Because this can stand at obstacles if you allow them to remain. If you are here this morning and you are here to surrender your life to Jesus Christ, you may have little or nothing to do that people can refer to. Because it's God that will have the success in life. You must be connected. And Jesus is the one that can connect you. Let every eye close. If you are dead this morning, if you are yet to give your life to Christ, I want to answer you to do so now. Lay your right hand upon your chest and say after me, say, Lord Jesus, I don't want to be wasted. I've had your word this morning and I'm ready to follow you. Accept me and write my name in the book of life. In the name of Jesus. If you have prayed that prayer with me, I congratulate you. Enemy will not cut you off in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Shall we please rise up now? Two prayers quickly. Let's be on our feet. Close your that warning to live a wasted life.
Jesus' name we pray.
because of those that did not hear me very well.
Lórí àwọn tí wọ́n gbọ́ mi dáadáa.
I said let your amen be so.
Oníkà bí rẹ̀ kó jẹ́ méje.
I decree to your life.
Mo pàṣẹ sí ayé rẹ̀.
Your destiny.
Àjọ̀mọ́ ti rẹ̀.
Your destiny.
Àjọ̀mọ́ ti rẹ̀.
Your destiny.
Àjọ̀mọ́ rẹ̀.
Shall be lifted up in the name of
Jesus.
Amen. 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 Amen